Good morning, and welcome to episode 23 of Getting Rich. I'm your host, Rich Chechen, president of Asset Strategies International, and today is Wednesday, April 21st, 2021. This past week, we saw a lot of range trading in the precious metals with a slight bias to the upside. In the news, we're hearing a lot about inflationary pressures. The Fed was out talking about the fact that they thought inflation was coming, but it was going to be a temporary type of scenario as a result of the pandemic and the recovery thereof. So that message basically stated that they thought that since it was temporary, that they could in fact manage the inflationary pressures. And the further signal there is that we were not going to see any rate changes. Again, there's no plans to do so for 2 to 2.5 years at this point, according to the Fed. So we'll keep our eye on that as things develop. I do think there are some stronger inflationary pressures, and I doubt the Fed's capability of managing that, period. They have no history of showing that they can. The spending continues. We're trying to force through this infrastructure bill, which has probably half to less of the money appropriated going to infrastructure and other the rest of it going to other things. No change, trying to pass through some pork and spend more money that they don't have. As a result, make no mistake, that bill for this meal will come due, and I think it's going to come due in two forms. First and direct, you're going to see an increase in taxation. There's no way around it. That is coming. The second, more insidious tax that you'll see is the continued weakening of the U.S. dollar, the loss of that purchasing power, and therefore a tax that nobody kind of notices, but make no mistake, it is there. And we're not seeing wage inflation keep up, so that tax will affect every citizen. It's gonna cut down on your purchasing power, it's gonna lower your standard of living. Looking at the prices of the metals this past week, like I said, we see a bias to the upside. So gold ticked up. It's trading today at $1,779.80 versus $1,743.20 last week. It's about a 2% increase. Silver's up to $25.92, just near breaching $26 again, versus $25.43 last week. That's also a 2% increase. Platinum, which was a laggard last week, is up a little bit, about 1%, at $11.92 versus $11.81 last week. And palladium continues to be the top performer, not as clear cut as it was a week ago. It's up about 2.5% to $28.18 versus $27.50 last week. As you can expect, that strength in the US dollar was short-lived. Last week we saw it at 91.70s. Today we're trading at 91.37 on the index. And the gold-silver ratio has stayed put. It was 68.78 last week. Today it's 68.77. I wanna let you know that you still have time to sign up for tonight's quarterly On the Move webinar with myself and my co-host Chris Blasi. We're welcoming Mark Skousen, who probably needs no introduction, but he's one of the top 20 living economists out there. He's a newsletter writer, author, speaker, and the producer of Freedom Fest. We'll talk a little bit about that upcoming in July in South Dakota. If you have not signed up, register below here on the link to do so. We start at 7:30 Eastern time. We'll be done at 8:30, a shortened format tonight, but you don't want to miss it. As always, I want you to go ahead and like us. So subscribe to our YouTube channel and like us by all means. Leave any comments or questions you might have. We want to field them on the air. If you go in the description paragraph below, you can follow Asset Strategies. You can subscribe to our free newsletters. And please, as always, don't ever forget, getting rich starts with keeping what's yours.